Hey, Chris, we got to film this intro.
No, I am playing WoW.
We need to film this intro.
No intro. I want to play WoW.
We need a video this week.
Well, I guess Danny up there is going to have to wait. So today we're going to be sourcing parts for a budget build in the $500 to $600 range, and we're going to make this into a multi-parter because we're going to explore different things with this computer. We're going to be exploring sourcing parts, whether that be used or new, because a lot of the times if you want to get the best bang for your buck, you got to include some used parts in there. It just is the way it is. And then how good that computer really is, so the build and benchmark as well, if you could even game and stream on a system like that, and then finally, how you can upgrade a system like that to go from budget to beast. So if you enjoy PC tech, hardware, gaming, and tutorials, this is the place to be. Hit that subscribe button, hit the bell notification, follow us over on Twitter. We'll be posting these as they come out, and you guys want the notifications on that, right? Right. So stick with us through this multi-parter and enjoy what we got. Now we got to go looking for the parts. Real quick, I actually want to cut in. This is going to be a rough idea of my process when it comes to looking up computers, value building, and all that sort of stuff. So it could be a little long-winded. I'm really trying to educate you guys to make sure you understand what you're buying and how I'm doing it. And a big part of that is going to be shown in this part of the video. So make sure you watch all the way through if you can. If not, feel free to skip around. I'll try to put some timestamps down below for when we actually get to the parts we settle on, and then we can go from there. All right, so here we are at the desktop. Kind of a rule of thumb that I like to follow when it comes to building computers, especially if you want to build something modern but still have a lot of value, is see what it will cost with all new parts. You start there, and then you start looking at what you can peel back in order to get more value, going into the used market. So we're going to go to PC Part Picker. We're going to put together a Ryzen build, since right now that's where all the value is. And let's look at how these new part prices stack up and see what I can make more valuable from there. Let's start with the processor. The processor, Ryzen 5 3600 is a very clear, like, awesome deal, but the 2600 is available online right now for $133, and it's honestly a great deal for that, to the point where it's almost pointless to get a lower tier of quad core, because you still get 6 cores, 12 threads, and really awesome gaming performance. The main thing with this computer is it's going to be used to play some new games and some old games, but for the most part it's not going to be something that needs to run 4K or 1440p ultra high everything. So we can get a lot out of it with a Ryzen 5 2600, so we're going to go ahead and pick that one out right now. We're going to add that one to the build, and the 2600 comes with a decent enough stock cooler that we can actually leave it like that, and that's where Ryzen, again, really awesome in terms of value, because they come with pretty solid coolers out of the box. Third gen changed things a little bit with taking out the vapor chambers in the center, but this is second gen, and I think they should still be good. So we're going to skip adding a CPU cooler just to add more value to the build, not have to spend money on that one. We're going to choose a motherboard. Motherboard is something that you can find secondhand, but fortunately B450 motherboards are already affordable enough to where you don't really need to do that. So again, one of the most awesome things about Ryzen ecosystem when it comes to that. So we're going to go with a standard ATX size motherboard. We're going to sort by price over here. And this is PC Part Picker, by the way, if you guys aren't familiar with it. Fatality B450 Gaming K4. It's got 4 RAM slots. Okay, so MSI had decent mid-range boards, but then again, with the 2600, we're not really going to be pushing it too hard. So as you can see, the prices go up really quickly. So we have the ASRock at $80. And I am kind of a fan of ASRock motherboards. This one lights up around the heatsink there. Let's see, Outlook PC has it at $80, but it's a mail-in rebate. So realistically, it's going to be costing $90, but it's $80 on Amazon on Prime. And that's good enough for me right there. So we're going to pick that one out. Let's double check on that, if it's in stock, that it is for $80. Perfect. Let's go ahead and add that. Not a bad deal. I know that B450 boards, and especially B350 boards, have gone for less, but this one is pretty well featured for what it is. 9 power phase design, so that's good. Blah blah blah. 3200 speeds, also very important, very good. And what do we got? We have, just looking at the board from here, I see, what am I looking at here? I'm looking for M.2. There it is. We got an M.2 slot right on there for way easier storage. M.2 prices, NVMe drives have come down in price a lot, so that's good. We're going to go ahead and add that. We got CPU and motherboard picked out already. Memory. So it's cheap enough right now to get decent speed. 3200 megahertz, especially since it's second gen, and playing WoW right now. I don't want to get logged out because of queue times. Anyways, we're going to sort by price. We're going to come down here on the left side. We're going to want to pick 3000 and 3200. There should be a lot of choices in that. I'm going to highlight 3600 just in case maybe there's a deal right now, and then we're going to come up to 2x. Let's see, modules, yeah, 2 8-gig sticks, basically. 2 8-gig sticks, we're at 16 gigs, and we're going with the value-oriented build. RGB might be nice to have, but it's definitely one of those things that's gonna be first to go when you're doing a build like this. And what's really important when you're looking at RAM speeds, especially on Ryzen, is the speed itself, but also the latency. So I'm seeing 3000 megahertz RAM with 15 and 16 latencies down in this price range. Once we get up to 3200 megahertz, the latencies jump to 16, still pretty good. I think that's gonna be the choice right now is T-Force Vulcan Z. Let's go ahead and add that. That's coming in at $67.99, is not a bad price at all. And it's $8 more than, let's say, the next reputable brand is Crucial Ballistics Sport, and that's Cas 16 3000. So we're gonna get Cas 16 3200 for $8 more. I think that's worthwhile. So we're gonna go ahead and add that. So now we have motherboard, CPU, and RAM. And we don't really need any more storage than that. That will do the job for the most part. We need storage. Probably gonna go with a terabyte, possibly. Let's see how a terabyte stacks up. We're at $280 total. Maybe we're gonna do 512. 512 has a lot of value, good amount of space for an SSD. Gonna click SSD over here. NVMe, just something to remember, NVMe is M key. At least that's what I remember it being. If you select M key, M.2 or M.2M, you should get nothing but NVMe drives, which will operate at the fastest speed over the M.2 interface. So now we're gonna sort by price. Let's see what we got. Mushkin Enhanced Helix and HPE X900, XPG SX 6000 Lite. All of these are under $60 for a 512 gig M.2 NVMe SSD. That is just awesome. Compared to what these used to cost, man, awesome. So, I like the HPE X900, to be honest. You guys may not know too much about it, but let's go over it real quick. Because it is a TLC drive, a lot of drives right now in that price range are going to be QLC, which have plenty of write endurance and plenty of durability, but realistically, TLC is still a little bit better, and we want to go ahead and pick that out. I show that it's actually not in stock right now, though, so let's pick a different one out because we need to get this build done, and we're not going to be waiting for no in stock. Let's check out Mushkin. Mushkin is a reputable brand. For RAM, so it's good to see them in this space. Let's see if this is QLC or not. It is TLC. And Mushkin TLC drive, that's enough for me. Let's go ahead and add that drive. And that actually is the cheapest one on the list right now, $55.99, so that's pretty cool. Now, you may get into like which controller is better and what kind of RAM it actually uses, like what NAND is actually on there. But, I mean, if it's got good reviews, you dig into it. It sort of falls off, so you don't need to worry about it too much for the most part, especially for your average user. That's more like nitpicky stuff. So now we're down to the graphics card, but we're gonna come back to the graphics card. Let's skip over that for now. We're gonna choose a case. So since we chose an ATX motherboard, we want an ATX case. Nothing that's smaller than that will work. So it has to be like an ATX mid tower specifically, or a full tower if you want to go a little bit jumbo, but a mid tower is pretty standard and you can get them pretty affordably. So I'm going to click over here to sort by price. And I see Raid Max in here, HEC, more Raid Max, DIY PC, that's a popular sort of affordable brand when it comes to value cases, even a Cougar case is in here. So I'm not exactly sure what we're looking at, but I think the Fractal Design Focus G is probably gonna take it for me for now, just because, oh, actually the DIY PC Crystal P3 looks good. Let's look at that real quick. That, does it come with all those fans? Let's have a look, because that could be a really good value if it comes with the fans, because fans ends up being sort of a hidden cost when it comes to these sorts of things. So where did I put that? Crystal P3 is here, and then we're gonna look at it over on Newegg. It doesn't have the best of reviews, it looks like. It seems like it's gonna be one of those cases that doesn't have a whole lot of airflow, and that's probably what the reviews are saying. Let's scroll down a little bit. This guy's loved all four that he's owned, cheap as heck apparently, but good space to build in. Weird power plug for the fans. This probably is proprietary fans that you see a lot of the cheap Amazon RGB fans have. And then there it is. Very poor intake vents, side panel shattered first day. Oof. Cool case, fairly cramped, had to remove the back fan before installing motherboard. Relatively normal, actually. But terrible cable management, yikes. First build for this person, but they wouldn't recommend it. Horrible airflow, there we go. And so there are a lot of choices in this price range. So we have this, the Crystal from DIY PC. We have the Fractal Design Focus G as well. And so we're gonna go look at a different set of the ATX cases, and then we're gonna go get with the buyer, the person who's gonna be receiving this computer, and see what they like the most. So make sure you stay tuned for the next video to find out which case we end up picking, because there are a lot of choices. Can't really pick right now. But I do wanna know what kind of cases you guys would pick for this kind of build. Value-oriented build, maybe not too cheap, but not too expensive. Maybe you guys have something in mind. Leave a comment down below, what would you pick? So I'm just gonna find one more option in here, and then we're gonna call it there. Let's see, Thermaltek Versa N25 doesn't look like a terrible, it does look kind of weird. Let's not. Roswell Nautilus? I haven't heard of that one. Is it new? No. The Nautilus is meh for the money, because you have these other cooler looking sort of better cases already. And then, all right, I'm definitely gonna come back to this one. Not come back to this one, definitely gonna put it on the selection list here. The Deepcool Matrix 55 is sort of a staple now on this price range. Now, Deepcool Matrix 55, Fractal Design Focus G, and the DIY PC Crystal P3, those are our choices for a case. So they're all about $50. I'm just gonna drop one of them into it. I'm gonna drop them, let's see, the Fractal Design Focus into our PC part picker list. And we're gonna keep on going here. Choosing a power supply. Now, so picking a power supply can be kind of tricky. If you want to just be completely sure about the quality of what you're picking, make sure you just go to Google and search PSU tier lists in order to find what you think might be the best on there. Now, there are a few power supplies that I'm generally very good with as far as picking, so I don't really need to refer to that list too much, but EVGA, Seasonic, and FSP are amongst my favorites, with Corsair also coming in there. But I'm not the greatest of fans of the CX series power supplies, so a lot of times when you're looking at budget power supplies, the CX series is all that Corsair has in that price range. So let's see here, we're gonna go at least 80, so 80 plus and up. So I'm gonna click 80 plus bronze, silver, gold, and it's essentially where the price are gonna go. So definitely we want some level of modularity, so semi and full, it's nice just to have. So, and then they've come down in prices. Unfortunately, tariff prices have made them go back up in prices. So things are really weird with power supplies right now. So it helps to really look through them and kinda try to pick one out that's good. Silverstone is actually a decent brand as well, so definitely something to consider. Now let's go down the list here. A lot of these don't have prices. I'm gonna have to make an adjustment here in PC Part Picker when you run into issues like this. So I have to adjust my wattage. I'm gonna bring up the wattage to at least 500 watts. And then we're gonna be changing the price rating over here to, let's say, at least $25, because realistically, we're not gonna find anything under that. Now I can change the price here and we have an actual results. EVGA BQ comes in at $54.99 for a 500 watt. I mean, Seasonic M12-2 620 watt fully modular used to cost that much, and now you have one that's not, but that's a semi-modular and less wattage. That's what happened with the tariff stuff. So yeah, power supply prices are not the greatest right now. Rosewill, I've used the Rosewill power supplies in the past, no issues, but a lot of people don't like them. Here we go, the FSP Hyper M85. It's a 550 watt, it's $70. It's kind of on the higher end, but right next to it, at the same price, is another 550 watt, and it's the Cooler Master MWE Gold. That is definitely one of the other brands that I do like to see. And at 550 watts, you have a little bit of flexibility with it. And we did use one of these Cooler Master power supplies in one of our recent builds. That was the one that we built in Vancouver for LTX with Danny and Oztox Hardware. If you guys want to take a look at that, it'll be linked up below and down in the description. Power supply worked out great, so I'm going to go ahead and go with that one. 550 watts, $70. Man, how prices have changed with those sorts of things. So for operating system for Windows 10, if you're buying new on there, it's sort of $100. You can go to websites like SCD Key. I know Brian from Techia City talks about them a lot, and you may be seeing them pop up in other YouTube videos, and you can get legit Windows 10 product keys for $10 to $20. So that's the route that I would go in a situation like this. And that way you can keep the overall value of the build really high and costs kind of low. So there we go. So I said we're going to be coming back to the graphics card, and here we are. So now it's time to choose a video card. We're at $452.95 right now. We have up to about $600, so we have maybe $150-ish worth of leeway now. And I believe most of the parts that we have are not anything we can sort of back off or tone down going into secondhand parts. Graphics card is mainly where we're going to do that. But let's see what we can get brand new, and then compare that to what we can get used and see what kind of benefit we get there. Okay, so clearly we're not going to be clicking RTX 2080 Ti in this one. We're going to be looking more at the RX 570s, 580s, 1660 maybe, if we can get one in the right price. But then also like the 470 and 480. It's GTX 470, no, 470. And then 480. So those should represent essentially what we want here. I believe I can't even recommend a 1050 Ti, to be honest, because in the same price range we get the 570s and 580s, and they will just stomp, they'll wipe the floor with the 1050 Ti. 1660 is pretty much the lowest we can go that we might be able to find affordably. And what do you know, here at the bottom range of the graphics cards are the RX 570s. And these things are monsters for 1080p on a budget. So we have 4 gig units and 8 gig units. Obviously you want the 8 gig unit if you can help it, but again, 4 gig is still plenty for 1080p gaming. And $120 brand new, that keeps us under budget. And we could save a little bit of money going with a secondhand RX 580, and we'll get even more performance out of it. So we're gonna see how that looks. Sapphire Pulse is probably one of the best looking and pretty well performing RX series cards. Man, I love the way these look, especially the backplate. You can't even see the backplate on this one, but it's nice. $120, it's $15 off promo, limited time offer from Newegg, which means that it is not a mail-in rebate, which means that it is a legit thing right now. So $15 off of $135, even at $135, not the worst deal. So that's the card right there, and there's the backplate. Nice looking card. I believe that's the hot ticket right there. I don't even really need to be searching too much more. We're gonna add that. $120 is what it ends up at. So here we are, PC part picker, full build done, ready to go. We're at $572.94, and then if you add the $10 for the Windows 10 product key, we're at $582. They're good up to $600. We got our build right here. Now, if you wanted a little bit more graphics performance though, you obviously want an RX 580 instead of an RX 570. And as you guys saw, that they go up in price real quick. So that is when we want to go over to eBay. And I bought a lot of graphics cards on eBay and never really had any serious issues, so I'm pretty confident in it. But if you're looking at eBay for any kinds of used parts, you really do want to do a few things first to make sure you're not getting anything bootleg. So we're going to go down here on the left side. We're going to change it to buy it now, just to get an idea of like what it would cost immediately. And then we want to do U.S. only, if you're in the U.S. If you're in a different country, mark it for that country only, unless you want to be a little brave. We're going to sort by lowest, and here we go. Now, doing U.S. only actually really does help filter out some of the bootlegs, but there's one more thing that you can do, and that's if you go to condition. Down here, we're going to do see all, and we're going to do new, open box, manufacturer refurbished, seller refurbished, and used. Because right now the list includes four parts or not working, and that can get confusing to some people looking at eBay. They think, oh, I got this awesome graphics card, it's got a really good price, and then if you're not paying attention and you order it, buy it now, you end up with a graphics card that has a broken fan or some other issue because you didn't realize it said four parts are not working. So the card may not even work at all, and we want to make sure we filter that out so you can get the most accurate results that you can. What is this? This is this dude. Look, you got to be careful of these. I haven't seen this before. This person has the Sapphire Pulse RX 580 8K. They're charging $5.35. They're not charging $5.35 for the. They're not charging $5.35 for the card. They're charging $5.35 to BIOS flash it for Ethereum mining. So pass on that. Clearly, the price was a dead giveaway. That something was different on that one. But now here we are, $89 free shipping for an RX 580 Armor. Okay, that's not bad. And we keep going down the list, $75 or best offer with $25 free shipping. We're sort of up there in the $100-ish range for a card that will outperform the one that we picked new. Power Color RX 480 4GB. We have the AMD XFX 4GB OC Plus version that would come out to about $110. Let's see if we can find a Sapphire Nitro Plus, because those are definitely some of the best. There's a Red Dragon, there's the MSI Gaming X, XFX is back, and there's the RX 580 Nitro Plus graphic card. To me, that's got to be one of the best ones. There is $120, buy it now. And but as you guys can see, if you wanted to go with a different tier RX 580 graphics card, you can get them under $100, no problem. Like, that's pretty awesome. I mean, look at this excellent condition on this Nitro Plus, though. That really nice backplate, man. Oh, man, I love the way they look. And it has a very neutral look to it. This color scheme sort of goes with anything, which is one of the best things about them. Like, you look at some of these other cards, and they're kind of dinky looking. The Armors are sort of the dinky looking ones, and you have the RX 480s, like, or 580. This is the Power Color one. You got black and red shroud on there, so they may not, that might not go with everything in your build. Even though it's got a very plain look to it, but at $95, $9.45, that comes out to $110, and the difference between that to the 580 is then about $10. Sapphire Nitro Plus becomes a no-brainer. I believe this is also one of the fastest ones, factory overclock, so you'd be getting even more performance for your money. Personally, this is the one I would go with. So I'm going to pick the 580 4GB Nitro Plus graphics card on eBay. Let's look at the description real quick. So this thing is your Sapphire RX 580 4GB, excellent condition, fully functional, stress tested clean, may include minor dust particles, not a big deal. This looks like somebody who took care of the card. It does also look like it may be coming from a miner, but when you have over 4,000 positive reviews, you have a bunch of them for sale available here, and it doesn't even look like the seller has a little bit of negative feedback, none in the last month, only 9 in the last 6 months. But you see here, they have sold other graphics cards and gotten positive results. So this speaks a lot to the quality of what you might be getting. This person said, this person left a neutral review because they didn't have the right power hookup. That wasn't on the seller, okay? That was on the buyer. So you can't even count that. Overall, the seller looks decently trustworthy, and then of course, although even though it says seller does not accept returns, eBay is still really good about the return process. So if you do get hosed, eBay will still help you out. Don't worry. eBay is really, really, really good about being on the buyer's side. Unfortunately for some sellers, some buyers do take advantage of that and sort of play the system. But if you're legit just looking for a graphics card on eBay, it's relatively trustworthy to be able to get your money back. $120. Now we're going to look at the build again. And it was $572.94 with the RX 570. We're going to delete that one off of the list. And we're at $452.95. Open up the calculator. $452.95. And what was the cost of the RX 580? That's going to come down to $119.95 plus $10. For the Windows product key, 582. We're coming out to the basically the same exact price with a higher performing graphics card. That is actually the best thing that you can get by looking at the secondhand market. You're paying the same amount of money, sometimes less, ideally less, but in worst case scenario, you're paying the same exact money and you're gonna be getting more performance for the dollar. That is why you go secondhand for parts like this. So that's what we have. What would you guys pick on this? Would you change any parts in this build for anything else? Do you know of any other better deals that you could recommend? Leave a comment down below if there's anything that you liked or didn't like about this build, or if you have any recommendations, yeah, drop them down there. My name is Chris. I've been your computer technician for today. And by the time you're seeing this, the build video might already be done, so it might be linked right over here, as well as any other videos that we have. So check them out. Linked all over here. You know you want to click one of them. Come on. You can do it. Click one.